In this section of Pranic People, we will look at emotional retraining and being ready, re-identification with what feeds us, infusion, immersion, elimination of all hungers, other gifts that we are given from aligning with our true nature and the pranic energy, the quantum field, the grandest love affair, permanent peace, emotional nourishment, overcoming our emotional body's conditioned addiction to physical food, plus the power of the path of a natural and organic transition, the problems of missing sleep or of having too much creative energy, and being ready on all levels, plus clear intentions.
Welcome back, everyone, to our video series, our free online video series on pranic people and pranic living and the gifts that come when we drop back into a different system of identification where we stop identifying with our personality, egoic natures, and begin to identify more deeply with that pure and perfect nature that gives us life and breathes us and can nourish us. Remember, we eat all the time. If you hear people saying things like, "Have you heard about the people who don't eat?" you can correct them and say, "No, they actually eat all the time. I eat 24 hours a day, 7 days a week without thought. It's automatic." Why? How is that possible? I have spent the time living a very particular way that has allowed me to be infused with, immersed in an energy that has the power to eliminate all human hunger. What I love about this is the other gifts. Imagine no more mental hunger. Imagine knowledge and information being given to you at the perfect time, in the perfect way, just when you need it, and sometimes before you even realize you need it. Imagine being able to sit in silent stillness and receive constant flows of insightful, inspiring, wise information where every cell of your body responds and goes, "Oh, I know this to be truth. Thank you." The quantum field is infused with this limitless intelligence. It is infused with this powerful pulsation of love that is so nourishing. In fact, the Pranic People journey is about entering into the grandest love affair that we can ever know. It gives us permanent peace. It feeds us emotionally in a way that we can never be fed by interaction in the human personality energy pool. Now, this emotional pattern of the way we have been conditioned to feed ourselves emotionally is one of the biggest stumbling blocks and difficulties in the journey of being nourished physically from pure prana. And this is what we wish to share about in this video now. When I began my journey with this, obviously, when you are bringing in something that challenges the status quo, there is a lot of biofeedback that is perhaps not so supportive. I grew up with an addiction to chocolate. I know the chocoholics in the world will relate to this, but my addiction wasn't so much for the yumminess of the flavor, but more the emotional association. My father loved chocolate. When I learned to cook, I also used to make him cheesecake. He loved chocolate. He loved cheesecake. He loved ice cream. And many of us have had that love for these sweet things. So when I moved in unexpectedly to the pranic nourishment reality, one of the hardest things that my body took a while to release its attachment to my emotional body was chocolate. So once a month around my period, menstruation time, I would have a feel that I wanted flavor chocolate. So I would have one piece once a month around that time. I did that for 7 years until one day it just dropped away naturally. And now I have no interest in chocolate. I mention this because I believe that things last when they are natural and they are organic. And I've noticed in the pranic people communities that there is always one food, perhaps two, that people have an emotional addiction to that they find is difficult to release. It's important that we are loving with ourselves and understand the bigger picture while we also retrain our bodies emotionally to receive nourishment, emotional nourishment in a different way. We also have to retrain our families and let go of habitual patterns of limitation. And this is what we will discuss in this video. For me, I meet my friends to do yummy friend things in a different way, but I've had to retrain them. When I spend time with good friends, we don't meet out at restaurants. We go for a walk on the beach. We enjoy a sunset together. We will see a movie together. We will maybe do a little shopping together. We do many different things together, but they are not around this constant ingesting of physical food. Think about this. Every social activity that is important often revolves around the sharing of physical food. When people get married, when people pass and the wake is experienced, when you go on your dates, your first dates, you're falling in love, you meet at restaurants. There is so many social activities that are great fun, where you bond so deeply, you share so deeply, and you have such enjoyment that then has an attachment in the experience around physical food. So people love this, and this is natural. Can we train ourselves differently? Of course we can. One of the things that I find, apart from training ourselves to meet differently when we socialize, until we can be in any situation without it being a problem, but it's not even that it's a situation you can't handle, it's just that you move into a way of being that you just rather do different things with people than this constant meeting up around the sharing of physical food, although that's easy to participate in as well when you are a pranic person. However, one of the things that I find is the impact of creativity, and I cannot recommend this highly enough. People who are in pranic consciousness, they are now nourished purely by prana, find that they are naturally a lot more creative. They play musical instruments, they are learning musical instruments, they paint, they are super creative. I'll do six paintings in a row, or I'll be playing six different musical instruments that I'm teaching myself how to play. I'm not very good, but it's fun. What do you find when you read a great book? When you are so immersed in a wonderful book, you don't think about hunger. You're not emotionally hungry, you're not mentally hungry, and you're not physically hungry. You are absorbed in the story in the book. Same when you might be absorbed in a movie. I love going to the cinema. I love movies. And for 2 hours or an hour and a half, I never think about anything. I'm just there in the moment, present. Same when I'm painting or playing music, or I'm playing with my grandchildren or my cat. I love cats. So notice that when you are really absorbed in the now moment, that you don't feel hunger on any level. You are just present as presence, watching and observing, and sometimes fully emotionally engaged. When you fall in love, do you find you're hungry or you lose your appetite? Some people lose their appetite. They're just fully present with their beloved. So we need to train ourselves to unhook from our emotional addiction to the pleasure of taking physical food until we gain this freedom that we have proven to ourselves 100% by the living of it, that this is something we can do. Now, once you've locked into this, then you maybe choose from time to time, as I do, to take a little physical food with family or friends just for the joy of this. And this is interesting. Imagine doing, as Akka and Camilla recently shared in an interview, that they take physical food maybe 2 or 3 times a week just for fun. Or Camilla, who shared that during her pregnancies, and she's delivered 2 healthy babies, that she might have eaten maybe 5 times just socially during the pregnancies, and yet she still had very healthy children. How can that be? Simply because all her vitamins, all my vitamins, all our minerals, all our carbohydrates, everything we need to be strong, healthy, self-sustaining, self-regenerating system comes from another source, comes from pure prana, from the essence ocean of infinite possibility, from formlessness as it flows through form, to use esoteric terms. So we train ourselves to be able to receive emotional food in a different way, especially when we're with family and friends. This happens automatically. Pranic people, suddenly look at this. You are not involved in digestion of physical food anymore. So you will have all this energy that your body used to do for digestion now available, and it will automatically rechannel itself into the creative process. Now, this is interesting because some people, when they've been nourished by prana for years and years and years, And they've been so creative for so long, they just decide they don't want to be like that anymore. They don't want to be in these high levels of creativity anymore. And they will drop their frequency back down to more density through the taking of physical food, because they don't want to be full on in this creative energy. They might miss sleep. And they want to sleep more. So then we have something that people can't understand. And we began this video on this to say, why is it that people in the pranic movement talk about now and then taking physical food? Well, we might use physical food not to give us energy, but to drop our energy. We're vibrating too high. We're too, it's too much sometimes. We miss sleep. Now, this is a big change in our bodies, because when we are not digesting, when we are being washed by this constant flow of energy, and we find our body is healthier and more dynamic and stronger and fitter and more energetic, then sometimes we stop sleeping. I've gone years with minimum sleep. I've gone years of maybe sleeping 1 hour a night, 10 minutes a night. And that was a big challenge for me. And it is a big challenge for many, because I like sleep. I love the dreaming. And I've had to retrain myself to sleep more. So some people may drop their physical energy levels by taking physical food for pleasure, for socialization, and because they don't want to be constantly in such high levels of creativity. So when I was talking initially about doing things naturally and organically, this is the personal journey where you will encounter many things along the way. I encountered big reaction from the Raw Food Network and many people who said, Jasmuheen can't be real. Because if she was purely on prana, she would never take chocolate. Now, many people have found the benefits of cacao, of raw chocolate, and they love it and they promote it. But a long time ago, this was seen as a big no-no. Also, people would say, I hear that Jasmuheen likes coffee, and I do drink a mushroom-based coffee. And I like it, a Gano therapy coffee. And I still find that's enjoyable when I travel. So I've come into being with this in a way that is emotionally pleasurable for me as well. And that's the journey. What is emotionally pleasurable for you? Maybe you got that your physical body system is receiving 100% pranic nourishment now. But does this mean you're emotionally ready, or mentally ready, or socially ready, or even interested? I meet many people around the world, priests and nuns and monks and shaman and people who are living an amazing life and in a deep connectivity as one with their pure nature, and they love physical food, and their prana percentage physically is 100%. They could let go of outside eating, but they're not interested and they're not ready. So let's go on and look at mental toxicity. We have emotional toxicity that we need to deal with, and that is this deep, deep paradigm where you have gained so much emotional pleasure bonding with others that has been around physical food ingestion. So take it easy. Let your journey be natural and organic. Maybe you, if your physical percentage is 100%, maybe ease into this emotionally in the rhythm of joy is grace. Set the intention to move into receiving all the gifts that your pure and perfect nature has for you naturally, organically, with joy and ease and grace. deeper immersion, purer infusion, pure essence. Now, that's our mantra, that's our intention, and then that allows everything to happen naturally, organically, joyously, and easily, without struggle, in its own way and time when our system is ready on all levels. Stay tuned for more in this series. This is Jasmuheen.